things that Orville Gibson had in his mind that he patented, the only thing that really stuck was this shape. The idea was that having taken the bowl out of the mandolin, he felt like it had lost some of its Southern European charm. And to make up for that, he decided there'd be a curve here. Actually, it was his theory that the mandolin should have air columns inside it. And he created these little bowls for air columns. And he even insisted that the necks be hollow, which was not structurally sound, and the mandolin's completely bowed up. So in 1906, the Gibson Company, he had sold out to a group of investors. The Gibson Company politely asked him, at full salary, to just stay home. So he did. And from then on, they steered their course in a more practical manner, creating mandolins such as this. This is a 1923 Gibson F4. Now, these mandolins fell, we'll talk later on how, but they fell into the hands of the Southern traditional musicians and became very popular for playing old-timey fiddle tunes. So why don't we try to do a few fiddle tunes now? Thank you.